This is gonna be four tips that you have to know if you wanna crush it, kill it, and dominate it. All right, guys, so check this out. So I'm here with Ian. I'm gonna let Ian start off first with our first tip. Ian, go and take it away.
Guys, number one, thank you for your time. Thank you for watching this video. So the most important thing out there to me would be connection. Connection. Without connection, you don't have a sale. You really don't. So how do you connect? Number one, how do you be liked from the minute that they pull into the lot? Are you playing chess? Are you setting yourself up for the sale? Or are you just walking through the sale? So the connection, I'm searching for who that customer is the minute they pull up on the lot. I'm looking at their car. I'm establishing who they are. I'm looking for bumper stickers. I'm looking for things that I can connect with them immediately on so that they like me, so that I have something to talk about. Guys, when you're talking to somebody, they want to talk about themselves. They don't want to talk about you. They want to talk about things that they like. So how do you do that? You look for things. You identify things. You play chess. You look at their kids, their family, the way they get out of the car, the things that they're talking about, their body language. I use these things in connection to build the sale, to make them love me, not like me. Love me.
Okay, guys, so the second skill I'm gonna talk about, it's gonna be mindset. Yeah, if you don't know where you're wanting to go, you're not gonna take your customer there. Listen, there's a simple rule that I learned when I was younger, and it works to this day. It's never changed. They came to buy, and they will buy, and they're gonna buy as long as I do my job. Now think about it. The only reason why they wouldn't buy would be if I didn't do my job. How many times does a customer come in and they say right out the gate, they say, hey man, we're just looking today. Hey, we're not buying nothing today. I only got 10 minutes. I'm at lunch. We're not doing anything. And all of a sudden what happens is that you change your mindset about how you feel about that customer and about how you feel that the sale's gonna go down.
Right, they're fall apart.
That's it. My mindset, this is a skill. My mindset is that, look, these customers, they will buy. They came to buy. They're gonna buy as long as I do my job. Yep. So what happens? What we do is that we treat that customer like they're a buyer and they turn into a buyer.
Right.
But when they tell us that they're not a buyer, our mindset has the ability to say, hey, this isn't a buyer. And it's trying to find bias to believe that that customer isn't buying. So what does the salesperson do? He stops selling, he stops giving all he has, and he believes that it's not a buyer, and ultimately they end up buying from me across the road because they didn't buy from you. What if you decided to say, hey man, regardless of what information they've given me, I wasn't around them when they had those thoughts. They pulled up with these thoughts saying this was gonna happen, that was gonna happen, and this was gonna happen. Was I able to wrap my arms around them while they were thinking that way? No. What I can do is control the way that they think now that they're with me. Mm-hmm. So when they say, hey Andy, look, we only got a couple minutes, I'm like, oh man, hey, this guy's just along for the ride. Yeah. He's buying today. He's buying right now, and I am not gonna act like that salesperson across the street that normally would be like, oh man, I got a guy just looking around. Nah, man, I'm gonna increase my energy at that point. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna increase my believability in the company, the customer, myself, the product, and I'm gonna give them a show worth paying for. This tip three, Evan, take it away.
Guys, it's all about confidence. You have to have that confidence and resonate with your customer that you're super certain on the deal. Now, how do you get the confidence? It's all about your preparation. If you're not prepared, you're not gonna be deadly in the sales game. I'm just telling you, you have to be ready for anything that comes up. You have to be prepared when they hit you with an objection. Ooh. That's how you breed the confidence. Now listen, if you're sitting at home playing patty cake and you're not trying to learn different objections and you're not training hard, how are you ever gonna be confident? Listen, Ian and I played, we role played back and forth until we were blue in the face. You wanna know why? Because we wanted to be confident in front of our people. Mm-hmm. Now listen, the best closers of all time, the best salesmen, dude, we beg for people to come to us with objections because we're prepared. We know every scenario, how it's gonna happen and how it's gonna play out. It's all about confidence, but you don't get confident if you're not prepared.
That's true. Hey, there's a difference between being prepared and truly being prepared.
Truly is.
Also, there's another difference is that if you want confidence, It comes from competence.
Right.
Right?
And it doesn't come from some fake energy of being arrogant or anything
cocky,
like that. Being
like
cocky.
That.
I'm not talking about
I've never met
a
closer.
Cocky guy.
I've never met a closer who wasn't confident.
Right. You gotta be confident and it comes with that preparation.
Yeah, guy says, I don't like this guy's, you know, I don't like his confidence. What are you talking about? There's arrogance, there's cocky, and then there's confident.
Right.
Look, I'm gonna tell you this. If you wanna go in and when a customer says no, get him to say yes, you have to be confident.
Right.
Because if you're not confident in yourself and what you believe you're saying, how can they?
Be confident in your product.
Right.
Be confident in yourself. Be confident in the way that you dress, the way that you speak, the way that you shake hands with the customer, the way you interact with their family. It all comes from being prepared.
Okay, so number four, this is gonna be skill four. How about you do this? How about you have a little bit different of a process than your competition? Ooh, think about this. See, I know what everybody's road to the sale is. I know what it is, okay? And I know what all your competition is doing. They're going into a dealership, they're shaking somebody's hand. You know what they're doing after that? They're going to select a car, maybe in some cases going inside and maybe getting a credit app or something. But in most cases, they're going to select a car, they're going to drive that car. After they drive that car, the salesman's gonna do something like, pull it up in the soul lane. Right there, that's my soul lane.
Yeah.
If you say something like that, you're saying something that the guy across the street just said,
yep.
And he looks at his wife and goes,
we got another one. We got another one, baby.
Another car salesman. You know, do something different. Make yourself different. Let me tell you, take your process, okay, your steps to the sale. Know it like the back of your hand. Change it up. I would create a different feeling with my customer and would give me the opportunity to really test them off the lot. When you're asking somebody to buy a car during a trial close, when you get off a test drive, there's lots of metal around you. There's lots of other cars. There's lots of ways for them to roam around and get distracted. So when I'm asking somebody for their business, I don't want any distraction. So I would purposely change up where I would ask for my trial close.
Mm.
So what I would do is that they would get in the car, we'll go on a drive, right? And I would be like, hey, take a right here, take a left. Oh, look, you want to drive it on these roads? Like, it depends on the car I was selling where I would have them take it, right?
I knew all
the pavement around me.
Yeah. Yeah.
Where they
you
would
were
ride.
Prepared.
Oh my gosh.
Truly prepared.
Truly. So what would happen is that I would ask them, I would say, hey guys, do me a favor, pull the car up right here. You see that little church parking lot right there? Do me a favor, pull the car there. 2 seconds, I wanna show you something. Just go ahead and pull it off, take a ride. All right, now stop. Everybody out, 2 seconds. Leave the car running, let's all get out. Get out. And this is control that I had. I would make sure all the doors were shut and I would step back and I would say, guys, come here. And I'd get right here and I'd say, listen, do me a favor. You see the car? You see it?
Yeah.
Now the reason why I took you out here is because when I purchased my last car, this is where me and my wife came to look at it before we purchased it. We wanted to really slow down and without all the vehicles on the lot, because there's a lot of cars, there's a lot of, you know, chaos and clutter going back at the car lot, I wanted to take it out here where I could really envision it and see what it would look like in your driveway. Guys, this is a beautiful car. Can you envision it sitting in your driveway, yes or no?
Yes.
Let's go back to the dealership. That right there is a skill. It is a skill. And I know the road to the sale. And you say, Andy, how creative can I be? Look, you don't have to reinvent the wheel, okay?
Yeah.
But you can separate yourself from everyone else. I hope this video has helped you. Guys, if you like it, share it with somebody, okay? Share it with another salesperson. Comment below, make sure you subscribe to the video. Hey, and see the number here. Shoot us a text message, right? Let us help you get together, help you with what your goals are, go to where you wanna go. I said the difference between where you are and where you wanna go is the gap in your skill set.
Acquire it.
Yeah, it's called skill acquisition. Let us help you acquire the skill that you want. We love you guys, we'll see you in the next video.